Now and the topic assigned the medical device related adverse events has somehow not been getting the kind of priority or attention it deserves, and patient safety somehow is considered to be synonymous with medication safety. But nevertheless, the medical equipment and devices also play a very, very major role in patient safety. So in next about 10 minutes or so, I shall be sensitizing you about what can go wrong with medical equipments, at what level, and what corrective actions can be taken so that such things don't happen. As has been amply brought out by the previous panel, that medicine used to be simple, ineffective, and relatively safe. Now it is complex, effective, potentially dangerous. This quote of Sir Cyril Chandler, when he stated this about 20 years, is as true now as it was then, and has been brought out by just now by Dr. Anupam Sibal, that with thousands of diagnostic possibilities, procedures, side effects, and cross-coupled processes, and modern medicine being technology intensive, though the technology helps in improving the clinical outcomes and healthcare prognosis, but when it is used inappropriately or when it is used carelessly, it can also pose a hazard to the patient or to the user. So to put the things in perspective, though we have been discussing about patient safety, quality, and excellence, but I still, for the sake of record, like to say that the patient safety comprises of three main areas or domains. First is the product safety. The accidents could be product related, that is the drugs. And the second could be the medical devices, that's what we are going to talk about now. And service related, like hospital acquired infections, suboptimal care or delayed care, or the other such things, then the environmental related factors, facility related factors like trips or falls or other such hazards to the patient. So our focus in this section is more on technology, and I shall be apprising you about the medical device related adverse events. Now look at this newspaper clipping. We don't have the hard data in our country available about medical equipment malfunction or failure. So most of it is anecdotal evidence, and I shall be showing you a few newspaper clippings in the next few slides. So this slide is, this newspaper clipping is as old as 1969. Even then there were accidental electrocutions that killed 1,200 patients in a year in US hospitals. Then accidents due to medical equipments are not uncommon. The newborn baby getting roasted in incubator, or the x-ray causing burn injuries, superficial burn injuries to the patient, or again this short circuiting in incubators that led to the death of 6 newborns in Government Medical College in Punjab in some time back, and last year in a freak accident when the cardiac defibrillator was applied on the patient, due to faulty circuits there was a generation of spark, oxygen cylinder was on, and patient was also on some dressing or bandage that completed the fire circle, and patient died of the burn injuries due to the fire, ensuing fire, instead of defibrillator saving his life that caused the death of the patient due to burns. So I don't know how many of you have experienced such accidents, but I am sure there must have been many, many near misses in your hospitals. And this is the domain of the biomedical engineers, clinical engineers, and I'm also not sure that how many clinical engineers are today in this gathering.